The final reason people do not master these skills, perseverance. Mastery is not about talent, it's about practice, putting in the practice time. And here's the wonderful good news, bad news. Following through, having tenacity, the willingness to push yourself past a position of feeling uncomfortable until you feel comfortable, these are exactly the qualities of a great leader. And so, of everything I've mentioned so far, this ability for you to follow through, work on your skills until you master them, that's probably the highest indicator of your leadership ability. You're willing to invest in yourself. So I encourage you.
Graduating this year, and that's that entrepreneurial spirit to make sure that you leave that legacy when you move on. And so we want to recognize Jennifer and Naya with our second entrepreneurial team.
Because sometimes I'd just be going through the motions. I mean, I was like 9 years old, reading, you know, Whitman and Dickinson to my grandfather. And sometimes I'd just be kind of reading the poem like this to get to the end of the poem so I can do whatever I want to do. And when I would do that, he would lean into me and he would scold me and he would say things like, "Mijo, you don't bring it to life with your voice, how can I bring it to life with my mind? If you don't breathe life into the words, how can they take shape above us in our imaginations?" So he's also my first teacher, you know? I remember one time when I was very young, younger than every single human being in this room. I was about 9 years old. I mustered the courage to challenge my grandfather. I looked him right in the eye and I was like, "Abuelo, why do you make me read all these stupid books?" And I'll never forget what he said to me. I remember it like it was yesterday. He said to me, he said, "Mijo, little one, este barrio, this neighborhood, is surrounded on all sides by gangs. Crime, poverty, violence. But when you're inside the book, when you're inside the poem, you are safe and none of that can hurt you." And with those words, a spell was broken. And with those words, a life was saved. Mine.
And how your presence and what you give off in your presence kind of lets people know how credible you are. And so it's important to dominate the room, dominate your space, and be courageous and confident in order to portray your credibility. Because you can know all this information and be right, but your body language kind of speaks for itself as well.
Officers of clubs, and also I work for housing as well, so I could take those back and use it to properly communicate within one another. And that also relates to the session Charles Neese talked about keeping a cohesive organization, so that way you guys can work together as one to achieve the mission of your organization without falling apart. It's a great conference. I loved it. I mean, I missed out last year and I really regretted it, so I'm glad I came this year.